Hi folks, I'm here with Johnny Licker at Haunting the Castle Tree. Can you introduce yourself? When did you start with Johnny Licker?
Hi there. Well, how did we came to the idea of starting Johnny Licker? It's about 1 year ago, beginning of last year. We were at a fair, a metal fair, and we were seeing that there were some metal beers introduced. Oh, that you could buy there, but when we arrived, they were already completely sold out. And since I'm and a beer lover and a metal fan, I was intrigued by that as well. And well, but searching for a specialized shop, web shop or physical shop, I noticed that in Belgium there was not such thing. So that was an idea that was growing and growing in my mind, and we started with the shop actually the 1st of June last year, and well, since then we enlarged also the offer that we're having, because in the beginning we had the most known beers like the Motorheads, Iron Maidens and so on. And well, by passing the time and also with all the licensing that that come with it, we are at this moment able to import from the complete world all the metal beers or other metal related drinks, because we are not only focusing on beers itself, but also on let's say the Slipknot rum, or whiskey, the Motorhead rums and so on. Also Behemoth coffee is one of our offers that we are having. We try to be as broad as possible, not only on in the metal world, it's our main focus, but because there's very much that you can find in there, but we try to extend it there as well. What we have learned last year is that you can also have some very specific beers, not only for example, like I already said, the normal Motorheads or Iron Maiden, the Entry Night of Metallica and so on, but also we have some specialized ones like the Rammstein that we are having now. It was introduced 4 months ago. It's one of our best sellers as well. I think that is also one of the beers that is staying. The other one that we're having since 1 month, I think, is the newly Overkill. It's because of the 40 year of the Overkill album of Motorhead. It's a tribute beer also for them. And what we are having currently on the European mainland is the exclusivity of the Cradle of Filth Pale Countess beer. What I can say about that one is that when it was introduced in England about 2 months ago, it was specialized, it was a brewed special for one gig in the UK. And it was completely sold out as well. And because of that, the brewer decided to brew a second batch. And they contacted us directly after it, if we were interested in distributing this beer in Belgium and also in the rest of Europe, like the requests were. So that's something that I came into, and now we are the main distributor in and mainly in Belgium for the Pale Countess beer. Our main focus is is at this moment still Belgium, but also we have customers in Germany, in France, in the Netherlands, and so on. So we are expanding at the moment.
Cool, that's a cool business for only 1 year. Are there in there 1 year already things that are not available anymore, but that are important message?
Yes, indeed. Last September-October, I had the possibility to distribute also the Slayer 666 beer. But due to worldwide demands are so low, it was only very limited. And at this moment, I regret that I cannot distribute it anymore, because we still have the demands, but the brewer has decided to take it out of order. So that's an unfortunate part that we are having at the moment. So, yeah.
So you're here at Haunting the Castle. You're in a medieval castle for a doom metal festival. How did you came here? So were you contacted by Djorga, or do you often go to festivals, or also like metal markets, or where can people can find you mostly?
Well, I go to a lot of concerts and festivals, not only doom metal but also others. And I'm not only I always taking my beer with me. This is still something that we are trying to see how it's working, where it's working, where it's not working. We are doing some metal related fairs as well. They are specialized in vinyl CD and so on. So we are an extra additional part which suits us very well to do this. And how did I come here? Last year I came to Haunting the Castle too. And I saw that they also have some special brewed beers here as well. And that came to the idea to contact Dennis as well, to see if we could cooperate and to have a stand here with some of our beers. And he agreed to it, so that's the reason why we are also here. Enjoying the festival and also making it possible for the customers that are currently enjoying the festival, that they also can buy some of the beers that they are not so commonly to be found in the normal supermarkets and so on.
Just curious, it's the first time you're here with the beer. How the reactions with the middle of the festival this afternoon? And did you sell already well?
I sold already some things, yes. Well, let's say that's always something you have to keep in mind. If somebody is like us, is selling some beers at a festival, people are not going to buy it at the beginning of the festival, because then they have to walk with it all the time. And especially if they are not here by car, for example, that's more difficult to have it. But I'm expecting a lot of more sales in the next few hours when the festival is progressing. And well, for me, it's not so important that I'm selling a lot. For me, it's important that our brand is being well known or better known here at in Wallonia as well, because we are not so known here at this moment. So it's more like a marketing part than the real selling part that I'm focusing on at this moment.
I forgot to mention you're from Antwerp. You go everywhere in Belgium, also Netherlands maybe? I don't know.
Currently we're only going in Belgium. The Netherlands, it's not possible because of other taxes on alcohol and so on. So that's always a difficult part still in Europe. I hope that they will flatten that, but I don't think that I will. So now we're only focusing for the fairs and for the concerts where we are with beers and other drinks, only in Belgium.
Well, it's a pity they have like a European community, but they don't get agreement for getting agreed on taxes. That's stupid. Now the most longest question I pose to everybody on my YouTube channel, whenever a subject I have. Suppose you're on a desert island, you don't have internet, no radio, no television, you can only listen to three albums, so three CDs or three vinyls. Which ones would you take on a desert island?
First of all, My Dying Bride. Because My Dying Bride is my all-time favorite, and the album will be The Angel and the Dark River. Second of all, it will be Metallica with Kill 'Em All. And third of all, That's the most difficult one, I think. But to have it somewhat more upspeed and more enjoyable, I think it will be Volbeat. Even the demo Beat-a-Meat. So
you have like important future plans, like a big festival we're gonna be, or anything like a special release very soon?
I'm cooperating at this moment to set everything up to be one of the guys who is delivering beers at Frietrock in the end of August. We're gonna see what that will take, how we can handle that as well, because at this moment I have no idea about the amounts that they need to deliver and so on. That's all in discussion. But that's one of the bigger things that is coming this year. And I'm thinking about setting up maybe or near the end of this year or next year to have an own small festival with own metal beers as well. The thing that I can also tell is that we are going to launch also our own beers later this year under the Johnny Liquor brand. It will be a dark one and a blonde one as well. So that are the plans that we are having at this moment. We have a lot more plans as well, but these are more future related.
Okay, thanks. With this info, I think people are gonna have like more an idea what you stand for with Johnny Liquor. So this interview was done by Jan Vervaeke for Jan Vervaeke YouTube, Jan Vervaeke Photo and Film Facebook page, also for the Orga today, Counting the Castle Tree, AZ Live, and for Metal to Infinity webzine, metal-related zine. Thank you very much. See you. Give some horns to the people.